sweet recipe. Today I'm going to tell you how to make sweet spelt pancakes. I've just been to the Fit Living Expo this weekend, so I've got a little bit of leftover of vanilla milkshake premix, so I'm going to put it to good use. You need, for this recipe, 200 grams of organic spelt flour, 3/4 of a teaspoon of salt, a tablespoon of baking powder, 400 milliliters of milk, and probably 2 or 3 teaspoons of vanilla extract. I've already got mine in because I'm using a premix for a vanilla milkshake that I did at the weekend. You're going to need some coconut oil for the pan when we're cooking these, and you need 28 grams of organic butter. You need to melt the butter, which I've done already. So in the flour, 200 grams of flour, you need to add your dry ingredients first. So in here I've already got a tablespoon for convenience of the baking powder. Then I'm going to add 3/4 of a teaspoon of Maldon sea salt, which is the best salt you can get. And then I'm going to combine these. The spelt flour that I use is by Stoneground. It's an organic spelt flour, and I get this from M's Bakery, which is a fantastic bakery local to us. They do all of their breads with sourdough starters, which is incredible, and they taste fantastic. Each day they do a different bread, ranging from rustic to wholemeal to beer bread, all of which have a sourdough starter. The best bread, that my favourite, is probably the rye bread that they do on a Friday, which is fantastic. Right, so now that I've got all the dry ingredients in a bowl together, I'm going to put all my wet ingredients together. So I've got my 28 grams of melted butter here, and I'm going to form a little well in the middle. So I'm going to combine wet ingredients. I don't need to add the vanilla extract at this point, but you guys will. At this point, I will add 20 to 30 drops of sweet. Which is 30 drops, 3 syringes. 3 droppers full. If you could like and share our page, that would be fantastic. Right, I'm going to slowly mix this in with the dry ingredients. This recipe does need to be sat for 15 minutes before you make your pancakes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause once the mixture is ready. The mixture will go quite runny, but it'll thicken up over the next sort of 10 to 15 minutes or so. It's sometimes a good idea to whisk it as well, which is what I'm going to do right now, just to make sure you get rid of any lumps. As you can tell, this is not a short and sweet recipe. So, you guys can't really see the liquid. It's kind of runny, a bit gloopy. I'm going to pause the video for now and then come back to you in 15 minutes. You're live. Sweetened. We are back, and it seems like only a second ago we were just here. So 15 minutes have passed, and as you can see, the consistency is a lot thicker now. You can leave it in the fridge while you wait for that to thicken up. It's entirely up to you, and it's in the point because we cook them straight away. So in the pan I've heated up, it's a 28-inch pan. I've put 4 tablespoons of mixture in the bottom of that. But first of all, I used a little bit of coconut oil in the pan and wiped it around with a bit of kitchen roll, just so it coated it but didn't sit in a load of oil. There is a slight coconut flavour, but it works quite well with pancakes. It's up to you if you want to use a different oil. But we love coconut oil, it's nice. And there are some health benefits to it. And, oh, look at that. Double. I could have gone two ways. So, this is now ready. So, perfect. And just so you know, you never took a question, how many takes did it take? Two. Honestly, two. That was good. So, I'm going to put a little bit of lemon on mine. We like them nice and thin and crispy. Mmm, this is fantastic. And once again, thank you to Em's Bakery, who I'll tag in the post for the organic spelt flour. Fantastic bakery, your life. Tree end.